Hello everyone, I'm Silverraptor and welcome to another Wargame Red Dragon deck creation video that I have prepared for you today. Now, with this deck, it's going to be kind of special because none of you actually requested this particular deck from the comments so far. I just remembered this deck recently and I have a real itching to use it again for fun. And I definitely want to share it with you guys because it was definitely a very fun deck. And this deck is exclusively going to be made for 10v10. So, we're going to start creating it right now. And what it is a... Where? Here it is. NORAD Airborne deck. And you're going to see why this deck is kind of special. I actually need to give props to Bubble Box, who gave me this idea. He and I had this deck up months ago, before all my decks got wiped and we started this series. And I definitely want to share it with you guys. It's a nice, fun deck to play with in 10v10. And if you haven't played 10v10, I highly recommend it. Just go in with an open mind. Go in not expecting to win, because balance is thrown out the window when you have that many players in such a small confined space. So we're going to go and put a NORAD joint air force. Spell it correctly. Okay, create. So you're going to see why this is going to be a fun deck, and I am going to start off with the reason why this is going to be kind of a fun, silly joke 10v10 deck. So, what we are going to do, we're going to turn all aircraft off, and we're going to select seed, and what we are going to do is we are going to get the Raven, we are going to get two Prowlers, we are going to get two Electric Voodoos, and we are going to get two Wild Weasels, and then we're going to select all there, and we're going to go to Helicopters, and we are going to get six Super Cobras. So, we have six Super Cobras with two Seed Missiles each. So six Super Cobras times two, that's 12 Seed Missiles. Then we've got the Raven, which has two Seed Missiles, that's 14 Seed. Then we've got the Prowler, which makes it 16 seed, or actually 18, because there's two Prowlers. Two Electric Voodoo, that increases our amount of seed we have to 22, if my math is correct. And then the Wild Weasel, which two of them brings that up to 30 seed missiles in this deck. And this is kind of why it's exclusive to just 10v10s. In 10v10s, so much is happening. A lot of players, and I am guilty of this myself, forget to turn off radar here and there. And you do lose a lot of stuff in 10v10. So, with the sheer amount of seed planes, you just fly them over and you're almost guaranteed to rack up points by just killing all the enemy radar all day long. So, that's going to be the focus of our deck. So, in the meantime, let's get time to wrap it up together and make it actually feasible for this style of play. So, starting up, we need to figure out what kind of fob we want to use. Let's give it a Canadian fob. Great Northern Neighbors, so generous on supplying all the fuel for our lovely offensive or defensive. We've got, we definitely need to get the Super Stallion, so it's going to be our Air Force. And, let's get some cargo trucks from Canada up. Now, we need to get some troops. We'll probably go a little skimpy on the CVs, because this is going to be exclusively in 10v10. There could be a lot of players with CVs. We're generally going to leave ours back behind, but just in case... let's go and bring some TACOMs and a Twin Huey, just because it has six strengths, and that minigun is after you drop these off in your home sector or whatever sector you capture, you can then use the Huey somewhat limited effect to infantry ground support. Now we need to get all the infantry tab set up and used, and Delta Force are now really, really good. And thinking of getting them in the Chinook. So let's get two Delta IVs there. We're definitely going to need the Eryx. Let's get them in the CH-153. Eryx missiles, of course, very, very good. Blowpipes are complete joke, so we're not going to get those. Highland 90s. Compared to Delta IVs, they've got a decent fire rate with their light machine gun, but the regular one is poor. All you would really use the Highland 90s is for the Eryx missile at range. We might come back to that. We need some Stingers. So let's get some Stingers and some Twin Hueys as well. Use up that. So we've got all of our AA that we'll need. Light Rifleman 90s. We could come back to that. What else do we need? All we have left are riflemen. Riflemen aren't the best. Here's a funny little tip. The difference between riflemen and light riflemen is that they actually nullify the difference. So what used to be end up is that the light riflemen had same accuracy or slightly better accuracy with their light machine gun and a higher rate of fire, but it seems that they balanced that out. It used to be that regular light riflemen were better than regular riflemen any day, but yep, I've noticed that that's changed. So we're not going to do that. We need to get regular forces. We need Canadian Airborne. That's what we need. Our shock-trained troops. So Canadian Airborne and Canadian Airborne 90s. Let's see. So the 90s are pretty decent. They've got a really, really good close quarters machine gun, the Mini-Me. And so we need to go with about basically need to choose cost. Let's get these guys. These guys would cost 50 each. They'd be cheaper than... All right. So we're going to get a couple of Canadian Airborne 90s. And we are going to supplement it up. We need to get some really cheap infantry. Let me just double check and compare again. These two guys. We got the small... let's get Rifleman 90s, just because the AT-4 weapons are going to be good. And let's get a couple of them veteran in Humvees and rebalance this all out. So I'm going to chuck the Eryx over there, move the Stingers here. And then we're just going to put the Rifleman over there as well. Okay, so we've got our Rifleman, we've got our Stinger Seeds, we've got the Eryx Missile Fire Support with our Canadian and Delta. So we've got all of our infantry tab filled out. Support tab, the only thing we can get are Avengers, and I'm almost inclined to skip because with the fact that we have Stinger Seeds, these are actually better, more mobile, and harder to see. The Avenger has poor stealth and actually can be taken out by helicopters before it can get into range to shoot down said helicopter. So I'm inclined to skip the Avenger. We are going to take a couple of tanks, the Airborne, for USA and NORAD. It's one of the few where you actually get tanks in this department. So we're going to get some Hardin M8 AGS for sniper support, sniper tank support. You don't want to mass these guys because these guys do die pretty quickly. You just want to bring them in just so they provide covering fire. We also want to get some Sheridans hardened so that they can increase the accuracy. Sheridans are amphibious. That is important to note. And they've got 5 HE power, so they're good for backing up our infantry. And they do have an ATGM weapon. So that's only going to be for our tank department. Recon, we are going to get longbows, of course. And we are going to get the Cobra for excellent air superiority or air recon. We could get this thing as well for vehicle support. Oh, definitely want to get the Resi. Could get him in a regular truck. Let's get him in the helicopter so he has the mobility. And we've got Rangers, we've got Navy SEALs, and Pathfinders as well. Z-147, hang on. So these guys are coming to C-147. They could come in and be cheaper. Let's do that. Okay, Canadian Airborne are going to come there. I'll have to fix everything again. Okay, all fixed. All right, now recon. We want to get probably... We do want to get some Pathfinders, I feel. Navy SEAL... Or actually, no, the Pathfinders are pretty poor in terms of... compared to the Navy SEALs, their laws are not that great. Rangers are good if they're standing still. Just double-check cavalry scouts. Okay, we're going to get some Navy SEALs. One in Progs, one squad in Humvees. Do we want Humvees? Yeah, because they are elite trained. So that will be our infantry tab. Which means we can fix this up, I think. Yeah. Let's get them back into CH. Because these things have 10 HP. Better than the 6 HP of the 173. And they've got longer range and autonomy, and they are faster. So we definitely want to get Canadian Airborne back there. Put the Erics there. Do this dance again. Do put the Rifleman back at the end. All right, good. Then we got our recon tab full out so that our air can see all the way onto the ground. Vehicles. Nothing is spectacular. We've got tow twos, but we won't really need that. So we're going to skip our vehicle tab two entirely. We need to go... definitely going to need some DAPs. Definitely going to need DAPs. Hawks, Seahawk. Yeah, we're going to need some OH 58s for some air superiority. Helicopters, try to shoot stuff down. Gunships, they could be interesting. Little birds. Let's get these. Yeah, definitely. Two Apaches. We got tow tooth there. Our Apaches are dedicated to tank. I know, we're going to get that Cobra, and then we're going to get some little birds because they're very small and cheap as well. And we got to go and organize all of this. Alright, Apaches are there. Yeah, this is a good organization. We've got our seed planes / tow-2s. We've got our dedicated attack helicopter with its Hellfire missiles. We've got the Cobra, which is dedicated anti-infantry with all that rocket pods and the twin minigun. We've got the Little Bird for grenade launcher support on top of the Cobra, in case we run out of that. And we've got some DAPs for good air superiority, or air good Stinger missiles, and some OHs for some backup Stinger missiles as well. And now we've got 5 more points to fill out. Or let's see, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Well, we can always move stuff around. Let's see. We need air superiority. Ooh, yes. These guys cannot come in at rookie. We're going to get a lot of F-15 Sea Eagles. We're going to get the D-Eagle as well. Phantom... two would be good. How's the F-16? F-16 is, yeah. Veteraned up. Okay, so Nighthawk on top of that. All right, you know what? However much, this would be fine. So the F-16s, these guys, good air superiority right here. Okay. Go here. These guys will go here to supplement the air superiority. At the moment, Phantom 2, because a line of napalm is always useful. And we get the F-18C Hornet. Compare that to the Thunderbolt. Now, I really like the Thunderbolt. I hated how they now added that if it runs out of Maverick missiles, it will evac automatically Winchester evac. And the reason why I'm a little disappointed with that is because the Thunderbolt's main focus is the Avenger Gatling gun. This gun right here into the center is the whole reason this plane exists. Basically, they invented the gun, and then they designed the plane around the gun. Because it's got 6 AP power that goes up against the top armor of tanks with 6,000 rounds per minute. So that will definitely take out any tanks that it comes across. But its Maverick missiles aren't exactly the best. So we are going to get the FA-18C Hornet, but we need to free up one of our points to do so. Where should we relieve up? Little Bird. I do like the Little Bird, but I think we're going to sacrifice that in place for dedicated quick anti-tank with the Hornet. Hornets are fast, and they are multi-role a bit as well. And as for Navy, which is just fits so perfectly, let's get the Tram Intruders. We will throw in the Tomcats. We're going to throw in some Super Hornets, the F-111Gs, and we are going to finally wrap it all up with the final plane, which is the Super Etendards. And of course, we are going to reorganize it as such. There we are. And yeah, this is our deck. This is our NORAD Airborne deck. And remember, this is exclusively for 10G10 because you have so much seed. You're basically trying to punish the enemy Red 4 players for not turning off their radar. And there's 10 players. Chances are one of them has forgot to turn off their radar on the other side. At least one of them, if not more. If you've played 10v10s, you know what I'm talking about. And you could just fly these guys around and skirmish. And yeah, just take them out left and right. I am starting to double think on something, because there are quite a bit of aircraft as well. Let's see, Nighthawk. You know what? The Nighthawk is more for strategic play. We are going to get rid of the Nighthawk, and I will get rid of the F-16. I'm going to putting in the double F-15 Sea Eagles. I'm going to put the D Eagle back there. Phantoms there. Hornets there. Now, I could have done the Tomcat, but the Tomcat's not really that good when it's been nerfed. You only get one total, even though he's hardened. Besides, we get our Tomcats in the Navy section in case of the 10v10 with Navy tab. And there are some, especially those straight-to-the-point maps. But, yep, this is our 10v10 NORAD Airborne deck. And I will play with this, probably on by myself, just for fun, but sometimes I will get friends in, and we hope to give you a good show. So thank you all so much for watching, and I do hope to see you all in the next episode. Thank you very much. I'll see you all later.